When we think of AI for video games, we think of opponents, bad guys, and sometimes our allies. But here's a thought. What if we can use AI to adapt the game based on your experience, creating new stories as we go?
We have all experienced it in a big action-adventure game. The enemy gives a speech, we get into a boss fight, we take them down, we move along. Sure, there might be some stakes to it all, and the characters might have some history. But it's not a story that we have any personal involvement in.
Two characters despise each other because that's what a story tells us. But the reasons don't really extend to our gameplay. What we did in the game didn't really matter, just so long as we reached the next checkpoint of the story. This is what made Middle-earth, Shadow of Mordor, so special. In this 2014 game by Monolith, your enemies learn who you are, they begin to hate you. They taunt you, and sometimes even hunt you down. You can learn their weaknesses and exploit them, or struggle to find a gap in their defenses, and you're forced to survive a grueling attack, all the while the enemy taunts your inability to overcome them.
What made this so special is that when characters in games develop affinity for the players, it's often fixed and predetermined. You can antagonize or romance characters in role-playing games such as Mass Effect, but the story outcomes are already baked into the game. The developers know every possible way the story can pan out, even long before you ever press start.
But Shadow of Mordor was entirely procedural. Those orcs and their stories are unique to your playthrough. Your time in that game is unique to you, and while your friends may have similar experiences, they will never have been exactly the same. In Shadow of Mordor, an Uruk might defeat the player in combat and mock you upon your return. They might run away and escape and remind you of your failure to take them down. All of this is enabled by the Nemesis system, in which each procedurally generated character develops their own traits and personality and could subsequently establish themselves as a senior ranking officer in this Legion of Orcs. While Shadow of Mordor is arguably the most high-profile case, it is certainly not the first time artificial intelligence has been used to build narrative in games. Experimental games such as Facade by Andrew Stern and Michael Matias pioneered AI-driven narrative way back in 2005. In Facade, the player is visiting a couple's house for drinks while they have a domestic argument. The two characters, Grace and Tripp, respond to your inputs, and what you say to them can shape the narrative with a variety of different endings. Facade was an amazing showcase of the potential of AI storytelling, even if it sometimes didn't really know how to respond to what you were saying. Story generation in games is still an area with massive untapped potential. Recent games such as Watch Dogs Legion revisit this idea by creating unique characters whose stories and lives are influenced by your behavior. From those stories, the game can create missions that allow that character to become playable in your DedSec rebellion. Once again, your playthrough is unique to you, and you develop connections to these digital characters.
The level of complexity in this simulation is massive in scale, but it's slowly becoming more manageable with better tools and a better understanding of what AI can do for storytelling.
Adaptive storytelling is but one of the many applications for AI in games, and be sure to follow along in our History of AI series to find out what the next chapter of this adventure has in store for the video games industry.